Hi, so we're gonna do a little update. Sorry, this is no makeup, just me. So we're gonna do an update as to how things have been going on. We went to the doctor last week before last, kind of that Friday, sometime in there. To kind of figure out if we were going to have to do IUI, and that was the suggestion. So, that's kind of where we're at right now, where we're possibly, not possibly, but am going to do IUI. I really don't know how I completely feel about that, but it. If we need to try it, we're gonna try it. Other than that, we started taking these Femara. Well, I started taking Femara all of last week, two pills a day for 5 days. And so Monday, I go in to have an ultrasound to see if my follicles are the size that she had hoped. So we will see at that point in time kind of what we're doing from there. Yeah, this has just been crazy lately. We had Jazz's son. A little comfortable. So we had Jazz's second birthday, which was amazing. But everything has kind of just been going crazy since then. So that was last weekend. That was before we went Friday before her birthday. So yeah. So this whole past week has been kind of crazy. So I was on Femara for the 5 days and I started bleeding, which is weird to me at least. So I was like, oh, okay, well, either it's doing its job or I'm having a period and this is not supposed to happen. So I called my doctor's office probably about 5 times yesterday, because today is Saturday. I'm trying to get them to answer my call to figure out what's going on and all that great stuff. Well, all this here. No one answered the phone. I didn't never get to leave a message, so I don't know anything at all as to what's going on. Look like a pale old lady. My intentions. I don't really care though. Not right now. I didn't even feel like putting on makeup yet, but I don't know. So I don't know what exactly is going on. And now it's time for a secret. And the lights go out. Well, it's actually, I look better with the lights out. Anyways, so, no, not all the way out though. Sorry. So what's been going on is, well, what has happened is that I took it upon myself because I've read in these pcos trying to conceive groups on Facebook that they had paid to have a conception psychic reading. I really don't believe in this kind of stuff, but I just did it for the heck of it to see what they were gonna say. So I got my reading back, and basically what it said is, within your next cycle, that I was going to conceive. It was going to be a girl, because my aura is pink, or whatever. I can't remember how it was worded, but basically that I was going to have a girl, and that it's so close to happening, so close to happening. So, and when it happens, my, what is it gonna, like my symptoms, like the things that I'm going through, I'm gonna think it's gonna be my period, and it's not, and I'm gonna have a lot of pain and all this kind of stuff. And I know how our minds play tricks on us as well, but I don't know how good your mind is of making up things like that. But this whole last week, the week before, I honestly worked a ton of overtime. In 1 week, I worked like 100 hours. So I worked 20 hours in overtime, and I was, well, no, last 2 weeks, jeez. Yeah, so I was completely exhausted. Just honestly, I was completely exhausted. So I don't know if that was a contribute of the pain that I was having, because my neck was killing me, my back was killing me. I've been getting really, really bad headaches, but I also sit in front of this basketball court light at my job, and that is absolutely ridiculous. They need to take those things out of the building. It's ridiculous. I do not need this bright basketball light to see a computer screen. My hair is crazy. I'm sorry. I didn't feel like doing anything with it after I got out of the shower, or my face, clearly. But other than that, like I said, I had the bleeding, and then I thought it was like a period, because it kind of progressed a little bit for 2 days, and now there's nothing, which is really weird, but it, whatever. I don't know what in the world's going on with my body anymore. I will say it would be nice if I was pregnant and I didn't have to go through IUI, because this is really stressing me out. Because, like, my job's supposed to be for fertility medicine and fertility assistance and all this kind of stuff, but then at the same time, I'm really, really worried that it's not. And to me, paying money to get pregnant is harder to comprehend now that we have Jazz. Before Jazz, like trying to get Jazz, I was all for it, whatever it takes. But at the same time, it's like, since we have Jazz, I feel like it's like a little bit of a regard or something. I don't know how to describe it, but it's like, I can't comprehend spending $300 and some odd dollars on an IUI session, $100 and something dollars on an ultrasound, and then my meds cost me $80. And it's like all these little things add up, and there was like this ARC or something like that program that we can get financed through for when we do multiple sessions, because you have to have up to $2,000, I think it is, or something. I don't know, but you have to have a certain amount before you can get it financed. So I don't know. I don't know. And I think not knowing is a scary thing. I never thought that after we had Jazz, I would have so many more problems on top of PCOS by itself. I never thought that over a year of Clomid trials, even though it wasn't a straight year, wouldn't work when it worked the first time with her. I never thought that I would be put on medicine time after time to get a period, to start back on Clomid, to see if I ovulate, and all this good stuff, and then it not happen. And then also, on top of it not happening, me have to go to a reproductive endocrinologist. And then they put me on medicine, and I have a cyst that I have for like 3 months. And it's there is a lot of stuff that's been going on that I never would have thought would happen when trying to get pregnant with a second. I thought that, okay, I can go to my doctor, she can give me the same routine and medicine that I had for Jazz, and we would be straight, and we would have a second kid on the way, and I would be pregnant. I never thought that I would have gone through all these things just to get pregnant, and then on top of that, have chemical pregnancy after chemical pregnancy, and have a miscarriage on top of that. So it's like, after going through all this, it's like I'm numb to everything. And it's like, sorry, my hair is driving me crazy. And I don't have a hair tie. See my fat face. I'm putting it up. So I never thought that we would be going through all this. Not only not going through this, but I can never imagine myself in the state that I'm in. Not state, but like where my mind is, I guess you would say, because I really just thought it would happen right away. That I wouldn't have to think about, putting money aside for IUI sessions, putting money aside for lab results, putting money aside for this, putting money aside for that. I feel like planning for a child and spending money on things for that child is a whole lot different than planning and putting money into the small percentage that it's going to happen. So it's just like that's where I am mentally. I can understand pain. When we got pregnant, I did go ahead and make a registry. So it's like I know I want a stroller that's $300. I know I want another couple of dressers, and because the ones that we have are kind of. But anyways, like there's certain things that I can understand putting money up towards, in like planning for the baby, or like having to buy some certain stuff, all of our car seats and strollers and mattresses and whatever we needed. I can understand that aspect of it, but it's the aspect that we're at right now, where it's like you're having to put possibly thousands of dollars into the shot of having a kid and then not even knowing if it's going to work or not. I feel like it's the lottery. And as bad as our luck's been, I feel like it's not going to get any better. And I just hate that I don't have anyone that's gone through this personally in my life that can be supportive and kind of understand where I'm coming from and offer some sort of advice or at least hope that it's going to happen. I mean, I don't know where we stand or kind of mentally, I guess you would say. So it's just a lot going on. Now my mom's messaging me about a wedding shower I'm supposed to go to. But Jazz is asleep and I don't want to wake her up because she never gets any good sleep. So I don't know. If you follow my videos, it would be nice to have feedback or something to kind of hear if you've kind of went through this. Or, you know, not. I mean, I don't know. I guess it's just nice to kind of vent and let it all out. Because I don't think I've shared with hardly anybody that IUI is our next step. Because I know nobody's been through it and I don't have anybody to relate to or share with. So. I think that's the hardest part of all this. But, anyways. It's no sad vibes. It's just kind of blah vibes. I don't know. But, hey. Comment or whatever. Oh, and just for the heck of it, I did take a test. So, while I'm recording, I might as well share that. Be right back. the results are in. I'm ovulating yet again, or whatever, but we're not pregnant. Or if we are, the test doesn't see it, so. I don't know. But have a great day.